Hi folks, so today we're going to look at another part of the five elements Pilates. This would be water. So water is soft, so air was light, water is more soft movements, a flowing from one movement to the other, and just changing state with ease. Obviously there are different aspects of these as you progress further, but to start with, we're just going with that softness of movement flowing from one thing to another, and a nice kind of change with ease. So, starting with our good posture, feet hip distance apart, knees soft, weight even on the feet and on the three points of each foot. Finding a neutral pelvis. And standing down through the feet and up through the top of the head. Relaxing the chest, letting the shoulders slide back and down and your arms hang loose by your sides. Breathing in through the nose and as you breathe out, activating your core. And breathing into the ribs, expanding as you breathe in, contracting as you breathe out, nice and soft, no kind of hard stop at either end, just and as you breathe out on the next out breath, you're going to rotate your hips to one side, and then breathing in as I come back to the center, switching across to breathing out as I go to the side, I'm just changing from one side to the other. As I change direction, there's no hard stop, just gonna bounce through that outer edge, coming up tall, and over to the other side. In good posture, but also soft. Try not to have anything particularly tense, so that I can change direction easily. And switch from one thing to the other. We're going to go to this side. And then as we come back to the center here, we're going to step back. Knees a little soft. I'm going to breathe in as I reach up. And then breathe out as I go forward. Folding down, supporting on my legs if I need to. And then rolling back up through. I'm missing a breath there. That's it. Breathing in. Breathing out. Breathing in. Keeping that lower back straight as I go forward, sticking my backside out, down, and then back up. And this time we're going to come up, and as I breathe out, then I'm going to go to one side. Okay, I'm kind of coming up, and as I reach, about halfway this other arm begins to come up and over. I'm just gently going from one to the other. Alright, I'm going to go for one more on this side. From up here, I'm just going to push this hand across, let myself rotate and extend. So I'm pushing this heel back into the floor. Pull in and push to the other side. Kind of bring the shoulder back and up tall. Last one on inside. Come up, I'm gonna step by the edge of my mat. I'm going to my roll there. Core engaged, let my head go first and my spine follow one vertebra at a time. Eyes towards the belly button, knees soft, trying to keep the hips over the feet, fingertips go wherever you can get to, find the floor, and then breathing out as you roll back up. Stacking the vertebrae, coming up tall, and then letting the head fall forward again. Rolling down, going as far as you can, and then rolling back up. Not stopping at any particular point. So I move through each space, pushing down to my feet to push the top of my head up toward the ceiling, and then back down again. So I'm going to go for two more. Nice and tall, we're going to roll down one more time, make our way straight out into our box position. So coming down, make sure you roll all the way down just like you did, and hand lifts up, bend the knees on both hands forward, down, so that your knees meet your hips, hands meet the shoulders, core is engaged, and you're going to breathe out as you slide your leg back, breathing in as you slide back in. Same on the opposite side, again, try to flow. Irish, and in, and then same as you go across. Nice and gentle switching from one side to the other. So there's no rush, but I'm not really stopping either. I'm constantly moving. Go for two more on each side. And just shifting, feel the weight shifting from hand to hand, from knee to knee. Lengthening the leg, straightening the knee, keeping the hips level, spine in neutral, and core engaged. Even though you're moving the legs, that's about keeping the upper body steady as well. We're going to sit back for a moment, bring my knees apart, walk my hands forward. All in one kind of swimming movement. And once I'm here then, I'm going to stretch back. I'm going to lift up and forward a little bit. And then back again. Chest towards the floor. Up. And chest towards the floor. And my legs are doing most of the work, so I'm the way to Z on my arms. And then on the next one, I'm going to come forward. Bring my knees in. Back down, let my arms swing down by my sides. Ribs are tucked in and core is engaged. I'm going to do the double leg kick. So, shoulders back and down. I'm reaching to my fingertips, extending to my head, and lengthening my legs. Trying to keep my belly button away from the floor, or at least keep the weight in my hips and my ribs. And breathe in as I relax. And again, same. Breathing out, engage everything. Breathing in, everything relaxes back down. Breathing out. lengthening and relaxing. Last two. Keeping the weight on the ribs and the hips, not pushing your belly button into the floor, you're not lifting, you're just lengthening. But once you've done your last one, shift back slightly, just have space. I'm going to go from here, just engage the core, float my hands off the floor, palms are towards the ceiling. And then breathe in, I'm going to bring my arms around, keeping my hands off the floor, palms down, and then back. Two. Trying to keep your arms straight and above the floor. Just going to do the one because the wall's in the way here. And we're going for eight in total. And last one. So come forward here, both arms are out, going to be in front. You're doing both, hopefully. And then I'm going to use this hand to push myself over onto my side. Turn my palm toward the ceiling. Ribs are tucked in, spine is neutral, core is engaged. I'm going to bring this top leg up to hip height, strong pointer flex. Bring my bottom leg up to knee, top. Breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. So if you're holding position, obviously you're working your core, you're trying to keep your length, there's no movement per se, so you're just going to focus on the flow of the breath. Just breathing in, breathing out. Do you want to add a little movement though? I'm going to add the arm this time. Kind of bring it forward and up. Breathing in as you go up, breathing in as you return. And last one. Bottom leg followed by the top leg. I'm going to get you to bring your knees forward, core engaged, toes together. You can float your feet off the floor if you feel you're able, but mostly just keep your hips stacked as you open out the knee. Just going as far as you can comfortably go without moving the hips. Again, if you need to have your feet on the floor, that's fine as well. Take the back of your hand, place it on the small of your back. And again, you're focusing on the flow. Just tipping the knee, breathing out, in. One. Relax down. Good. From here, I'm going to push up to seated. I'm going to sit and face this way. Again, transitioning nicely into my roll up. So, core engaged. Tilt my pelvis. Maybe tilting and rolling back. Again, my quarter is going as far as you can go, breathing in. And then breathing in as you come. Add a little more. Breathing in, you're still tall. Pushing down through the sit bones. Breathing out. Breathing in. Breathing out. Breathing out. Keep in mind the arms move on the in breath, not on the in and out breath. So if you breathe in, they go out and come back. And while you're still breathing in, so you can breathe out as you roll them. Breathing in, you're still tall. If you're able, you can roll over the sacrum, finding that lowest vertebra, in which case you bring the back a little bit. Again, they still go in the in-breath, and you breathe out as you roll. Again, you're aiming for flow here, so if you can't go down and back up smoothly, just go where you can. we're doing this in earth, we might get you to go down and come back up, because we're really trying to ground, find where we're putting the weight, you're building the muscle. But in this, we're trying to work on moving smoothly. So air, we're trying to move lightly. Water, we're trying to move smoothly. Earth, we're trying to ground. Fire, we're trying to move its pace. Good. And last one. And keep the arms going. Hard to focus on everything while you're talking. Good. Then bring my feet in. Core engaged. I'm gonna float one leg up. Imprint my spine, float my other leg up, return my spine to neutral. Use coffee table. From here I'm gonna breathe out. Bring my arms back. Breathe in as I come up and look forward. Hug your knees in a little if you like, and then just return the knees to coffee table as you go back. Just work that core a little more. Again, always with that flow. No sudden stops. Breathing in as you go out. In as you come in. Start with the talking. Sometimes the breathing gets switched around for myself. Last one, and then you can hook your knees in, rest your head and shoulders, and then we're going to go straight into the 100. So from here, core engaged, just going to bring your legs back to coffee table. You feel you're able, you can lift your head and shoulders and then lengthen your arms. Try and move again with flow, so not like this and not the lightness that we had there. Core engaged, breathing out. Keeping the arms straight still, keeping a nice flowing motion. Strong point of flex, imprinted spine, belly button drawn in, core engaged. Last one. And again, go again. Adding your knees in. Good. When you're ready, you roll to the side. From here, pushing your way up to seated. Then we're into the spine stretch. It's coming up tall, shoulders back and down, and core engaged. Breathing in. Breathing out. Imagine you're like a wave crashing in, coming up and over, and drawing back out. Time. And from here, swing your legs out to the side and down onto your other side of your side kick. And then core engaged, gonna float one leg up, float the other leg up, keeping that sense of space between the hips and the ribs. So the weight is in the hips and the shoulder or in the upper ribs. And again, just breathing with the following the flow of the breath. If you're able, you can add your own. And then you may find your balance better on one side than you do on the other. And one leg down, followed by the other, and bring your knees forward again. You can float your feet up if you feel you're able. Back of the hands here to keep an eye on your lower back or your hips. Feet down, gonna roll onto your back. And I'm just gonna go into some mobility, flexibility. So bring your feet a little bit wider, out to the edges of the mat. And then from here, let your knees fall to the right. You bring your arms out a little bit wide, keep the shoulders on the floor. The back up tall, and fall into the other side. So with water, I don't so much stretch, so I just want to mobilize. Let's say you shouldn't stretch. After a water workout, but keeping the theme. Just trying to flow from one thing to another, just loosen things out rather than trying to hold and stretch. I'm going to go for one more on each side. And I'm going to come down again onto this side. Bring this both hands forward like so, and then rest. I'm going to open out my upper body and keep my knees together on the floor. So go for five. You can look, keep looking forward, or you can follow your hand to make sure you're keeping your knees down on the floor. This time, I'm going to open it. I'm going to let my knees come up. So I'm pushing with this hand a little bit. I'm going to switch over. Gently sit up. Do the other side. Same thing. Open it. muscle. From here, I'm just going to tilt my pelvis a little bit down. So I'm not really pushing into the floor. I'm going to tilt a little bit. I'm going to tilt the other way again. Not really arching. Just a little flattening and a little arching. I'm just rocking the hips back. It's just to warm up the hips and the lower back area. Just let them stretch out. Creating space in the lower back. Rocking back and forth, so just letting this kind of ease out and relax. The idea is to do it for 25, 50, 75 times, or like for 30 seconds to a minute to 2 minutes. And back to neutral. Your knee fall out a little bit and then slide your foot out. And just letting the knee fall out just stops you from kind of lifting the foot. So let the knee fall out and you can just slide the leg up. Just takes the pressure off the back. And we're going to go into our body awareness and our relaxation. Thank you very much. Enjoy. Let the feet fall out to the side, palms toward the ceiling. Shoulders relax back and down. Gently tense your feet. Calves, thighs, hips and glutes, abs and lower back, chest and upper back, hands, arms, shoulders, squeeze and release. Breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. And again, start with the feet. Then the calves, then the thighs, the hips and glutes, abs and lower back, chest and upper back, hands, arms, shoulders, squeeze, and release. In through the nose and out through the mouth. Then deep breath in when you're ready, filling up the lungs. Holding for a moment. And release. Deep breath in again, filling up the lungs. Gathering any tension in the body up into the chest and holding it there for a moment. Making sure you collect it all. Mix it with the air. And then release. One last time, deep breath in. Holding for a moment. And as you release, just melting into that. Breathing normally down into the nose and out through the mouth. Be aware of the sounds and sensations around you. Focus on the breathing in and breathing out.
fingers in.
Your toes.